Hello, so today we're going to look at chest CT and we're going to look at bronchial anatomy. For me, this is a really important thing to look at. So every time I look at a chest CT, I'm sure to follow all of the airways that I can see. Why is that important? Well, there are times where you might see an endobronchial lesion within an airway, which if you're not following all of the airways, it may be easy to miss. Worst case scenario, that can mean missing a lung cancer. Also, if you know that all of the segments that should be there, you're then aware when something's missing. And again, that could be because of lung collapse. Worst case scenario, again, that could be a lung cancer. So if you want to accurately read chest CT, this for me is a really important thing to know. So what can we see on CT? Well, firstly, we obviously can see the trachea. Then we can see all of what we call the large airways. So we can see that splitting at the carina into right and left main bronchus. We can then see those airways split off into the lobar airways, then into segmental and subsegmental airways. What we don't see so well on CT is the small airways. You've got to remember those airways then split off multiple times, multiple generations of bronchi, which we don't see directly, but we can see some indirect findings, such as central lobular nodules, tree and bud nodularity, and sometimes mosaic attenuation. Now, remember the basic anatomy. The right lung has three lobes, upper, middle, and lower, whereas the left only has two, upper and lower. The equivalent of the middle lobe on the left is the lingula, which also forms part of the upper lobe. So let's have a look. Firstly, obviously, we can see this black thing in the middle is the trachea. So I've flipped it onto lung windows here. That's the best way to look at the airways. This in the middle is your trachea. Now we're going to follow that down and that splits off here at the carina into right and left main bronchus. On the right, we can see this kind of whale shape here. Now I know whenever I see this whale shape, that means you've got the right upper lobe bronchus coming off. So remember, the whale means right upper lobe bronchus. The right upper lobe then has three segments, apical, posterior and anterior. So let's have a look at those. We can see firstly the anterior segment coming off here, obviously going anteriorly. We can then see the posterior segment coming off here. And then obviously your apical segment's going to come off and go towards your lung apex. So these are your apical segmental airways. So three segments of your right upper lobe. Once that right upper lobe bronchus has come off, the airway is then called your bronchus intermedius. Now that's going to split into two. That's going to split into your middle lobe, which goes anteriorly, and then your lower lobe, which comes off posteriorly. So let's have a look at that now. So this here is your bronchus intermedius. And if we come down, we can see your middle lobe airways coming off here and your right lower lobe airways coming off here. Now the middle lobe, fairly easy to remember, has only two segments, the medial and the lateral, and they sit side by side. So the medial segment here sits next to your right heart border. So remember on your chest x-ray, if you ever get the loss of silhouette sign, it's because you've got pathology within the medial segment of your middle lobe. That's the bit that sits next to your right heart border. So medial and lateral segments in your middle lobe. Lower lobe, bit more complicated. I like to think of the lower lobes like a house where you've got two floors. You've got the top floor, which is a bit like a loft and only has one room. And then you've got your bottom floor, which on the right has four rooms. So the top floor on the right lower lobe here, you have your apical segment bronchus, which is a little bronchus which just comes off straight away when you've got your right lower lobe airway. Apical segment, and then the bottom floor has four rooms. Number one, you've got your medial segmental bronchus, which is already split off into two here. You've got your anterior segmental bronchus here. You've got your lateral bronchus here and then your posterior bronchus here. So the mnemonic I like to use is probably commonly used, the word MALP. Yes, I know it's not a word, but it helps me remember the four basal segments of the right lower lobe. So what are we looking for when we're following the airways? Well, there's three things that I like to look for. Number one, you're looking to see, are the airways dilated? So if we zoom up here, this is one of your posterior segmental airways, and this is the accompanying pulmonary artery. The airway should be smaller than the accompanying pulmonary artery. And by that, I mean the internal diameter of the airway. That's normal. A ratio of 1:1 is okay, but once your airway is bigger than your corresponding pulmonary artery, then we term that bronchiectasis. It's abnormal dilatation. That's number one. What else are we looking for? Number two, you're looking to see if the airway is obliterated at all. So you want to see black, basically, reflecting gas within the airway. If you've got some kind of soft tissue within the airway, that could either mean you've got mucus, most commonly, or in some cases, you can have endobronchial tumour. A common primary endobronchial tumour in the lung is carcinoid. Number three, you're looking for bronchial wall thickening. So you should see a nice pencil thin line in terms of the wall of the bronchus. Once that becomes thickened, you know you've got some inflammation within the bronchus there. So three things. Number one, dilatation. Number two, anything filling the airways. And number three, any thickening of the walls of the airways. So that's the right side. Now we're going to have a look at the left side as well. So we're going to scroll up. Now here's the carina. We've got right upper lobe bronchus coming off. Here we've got the left upper lobe bronchus, and we can see that over here. Instead of three segments on the right side, you've only got two segments on the left side. So once you know all of your right-sided anatomy, I like to think of the left side as having three main differences with the right. Each of the different lobes, if it were. Number one, in terms of the upper lobe, instead of apical and posterior segments, you've now got apico-posterior segment. Instead of a middle lobe, you've got a lingula. And within the lower lobe, in terms of the basal segments, instead of anterior and medial separate segments, you've now got an anteromedial segment. So, left upper lobe has two segments. Let's have a look at those. So this should now split off into two, which it does there. So you can see anterior segment here and the apico-posterior segment there. And we can follow that up. So the upper lobe bronchus has come off. Straight away, you've got the lingula. And that will split off into two. So instead of on the right of having the middle lobe, which splits off into medial and lateral segments, on the left, the lingula splits off into superior and inferior segments, which sit on top of each other rather than side by side like on the right. So here you've got the superior segmental bronchus of the lingula. And if you follow it down, then you've got the inferior segmental bronchus here going to the lung base on the left there. So on the left, in terms of the lower lobe, again, you've got the two floors. You've got the apical segmental bronchus here. So that's the top floor of the house. And then you've got your basal segments. So instead of four rooms, we've now got three. The monic this time is ALP rather than MALP. So those anterior medial segments are now joined together to form the anteromedial segment. You've got the lateral segmental bronchus here and the posterior segmental bronchus here. And we can follow those all the way down. And that's all there is to it. So every time I look at a chest CT scan, I'm sure to look at all of those airways in turn every single time. When you're learning at the beginning, it can be quite tricky. So what I used to do, there's a fantastic article on the Radiopaedia website called Bronchopulmonary Segments, which I always had up on a screen next to me when I was looking at a chest CT. And once you do that 20, 30 times, those segments then become ingrained in your brain. And every time you look at a chest CT, it then becomes quite easy to look at. So let's look at another case. So here we've got another chest CT. Carina is here. I can see my whale here. So this is the right upper lobe bronchus I can see over here. That's going to divide into three. So it's going to go into anterior. It's going to go into posterior and also the apical segment, which comes up here. That becomes bronchus intermedius, and then that divides into middle lobe. So we've got medial and lateral segments over here. So this is the medial segment, and that is the lateral segment over there. I'm going to go back up. I'm going to look at my right lower lobe this time. This is the apical segmental bronchus coming off here. And then the four rooms of the house. So here I've got medial, anterior, lateral, and posterior. So if I follow these down, I can see that they become abnormal. So what I can see here is that, remember we said, if the airway becomes bigger than the corresponding pulmonary artery, it's bronchiectasis. And this is what you've got here. So you've got posterior segmental and also medial segmental bronchiectasis here. There's different types of bronchiectasis, and it's a bit of a spectrum, from a cylindrical bronchiectasis, where you get a tubular dilatation of the airway, varicose, where you get beading of the airways, and then what you've got here is a cystic appearance, so the most severe of those three forms. So this is a cystic bronchiectasis within the right lower lobe. Let's look at another case. Okay, so here we've got another case. Trachea, I can see, is going to split off into, at the carina, to the right and left. So we've got a whale shape coming off here. Right upper lobe splits off into anterior, posterior, and then apical segmental bronchi. Once that comes off, bronchus intermedius. Anteriorly into middle lobe with medial and lateral segments. Right lower lobe bronchus I can see here. I'm going to come back up and have a look at the apical segment, which is over here. And then the four segments at the bottom of the right lower lobe. So medial, anterior, lateral, and posterior. Now we'll look at the left upper lobe. So back up to the carina, left upper lobe bronchus comes here, but look what happens. You lose it within this mass here. So here you've got left upper lobe collapse due to an occluded left upper lobe bronchus, which was later proven on bronchoscopy to be due to a left upper lobe lung cancer. I hope you found these cases useful. There'll be more coming up on Chest CT in the coming weeks, so please do subscribe if you want more.